Hello, math class. We're going to move quick on the review guide for our chapter quiz. So we want to write this answer as a mixed number. So let's zoom in. We've seen these before. So we're going to multiply, then add. Multiply. Then add. Find the common denominator, which is 6. Multiply by the giant 1, 2 over 2. Use your multiplication chart. Subtract. 20 minus 11, is 9, reduce, or simplify. Actually, we don't want to, we could reduce, but remember it says to mix number in simplest form. Yeah, so we'll reduce. Let's reduce. Divide by 3. End up with 3 over 2 as a mixed number. 2 divides into 3 once. Subtract 2 times 1 is 2. Get 1. So the remainder is 1 and the divisor is 2. So it's 1 and 1 half. Now I'm going to come right back. It's a little loud with the movie in the background there. So I'll return, give you a chance to write that down. All right, number 2, write your answer as a decimal. And so we've got these two decimals. So what I remember about this kind of question is you're subtracting. So you could add a negative number. So these are same signs. So when you subtract and just keep the sign of the answer, which is negative. So keep the same sign, right? And so I'll take these values, line up the decimal points, add them up, bring down the decimal. That's the answer. So it's going to be negative 12. You don't have to put 0.0. See how here I have 12.0. You don't have to do that. Just 12 is fine. But don't forget the negative sign. It'd be wrong if you didn't. This is the answer right there with the happy face. You got it? All right, number 3. It says find the distance on the number line. Write your answer as a decimal. We talked about the distance formula, right? I called it D. I said the first number minus the second number in absolute value so that the answer you get is positive because distance is always positive. The order in which you write these doesn't matter, right? Doesn't matter. So let's substitute. All right, and so what I know is, write it that way, right? And so they're both negative, see it? See they both have a negative sign? So line up the decimals, add them up. And I'm moving quick today because we have quite a bit to cover and not a whole lot of time. So the absolute value of 9.2 is 9.2. That's your answer that goes in this box. Alrighty? Okay, keep moving. And again, you could pause this video on your own time, but for now, we're moving. Write your answer as a mixed number. You're dividing. Oh, yeah. So the keep, change, flip. Before you do any of that, though, you want to write this. Write these as improper fractions. So let's keep, change, flip. One of the things that I'd mentioned is that you can simplify before you multiply, right? And so you see that the 2 goes into 2 once, and 2 goes into negative 10, negative 5 times. See that? Here, 32, if you get 8 and 4, 3, so no, we're not going to reduce there. No. I don't think I see it. So now let's multiply straight across. So we're going to take 15. So you get 25, carry the 2, negative 75 over 32. Now it says to write it as a mixed number in simplest form. All right. So this is the answer as an improper fraction. As a mixed number, it's going to be, remember, it's going to be a negative answer, so I'll put a negative sign there. So we'll get 2 here. 2 times 2 is 4. 3 times 2 is 6. Subtract, you get a remainder of 11. All right? So it's remainder 11 over 32. And don't forget the negative sign. So this is the answer. Here. And that goes in that box. All right? It's negative 2 and 11. 30 seconds. Wow, what a question. So, yes, I want to talk more, but I can't. So I'm going to zip on through here. You stay focused, concentrate. You're doing good. All right, number five, it says, write your answer as a decimal. So we're multiplying decimals. I got that. Write your answer as a decimal. So different signs. The answer is going to be negative. Let's do this. Here, when you multiply decimals, just line up the digits on the right side. In other words, if there was another number here, like 1, the decimal was here, that's how you'd line it up, right? Right. But that's not the case, so we're not lining up decimal points. We're not. Trust me. Not doing it. Okay, there we go. So it's going to be a negative answer. So you get 3 times 1 is 3. 1 times 4 is 4. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 times 4 is 8. See that? And you add these values. And let's get rid of that. So you end up with 3. 10, carry the 1. 9. You've got 2 digits to the right of the decimal. So your answer has to have 2 digits to the right. And that's your answer, 9.03. It's negative, though. That's how you do it. Okay? Moving right along. Number 6. And I'll give you a chance to write that down. I'm going to step out for a second. Thank you. All right, so this question, there's a lot going on. You're going to multiply. And so let me zoom in, write your answer in simplest fraction form. So always work within the parentheses first. And so, and then here we're going to multiply straight across. Not finding common denominators. And we've got two negative signs. So they're same sign. So when you're multiplying two numbers with the same sign, it's going to be a positive answer. So eventually this negative sign will multiply with this negative sign and your answer is going to be positive, okay? So 4 times 3. 4 times 3 is 12. 6 times 4 is 24. This here is a multiplication symbol. It's another type of parentheses called a bracket. So now you have two negative signs that'll be positive. So now we're going to reduce before we multiply. Okay? Now, 4 goes into 4 once, and 4 goes into 24 6 times. You've got to know your multiplication facts. Otherwise, reducing is going to be too difficult. 2 goes into 10 5 times, and 2 goes into negative 12 negative 6 times. So see what I just did? I reduced. Now, here's what's interesting. You can reduce again, but I'm going to hold off. I'm going to multiply first. There's another reduction. Let's just wait on that, though. So 1 times, now watch, there's a negative sign there. So it's negative 1 times negative 6 over 5 times 6. And I can see 6 over 6. That would be just negative 1. Let's do that. See this here? Negative 6. Positive 6, if you divide, you get 1 over negative 1. And now you get negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1 in the numerator. 5 times 1 is 5. And that's your answer. So there's a lot going on there. But, you know, think about it. See if it makes any sense. Yeah. Demanding. Get that there for a second. Okay, number 7. It says that we have a rectangular prism that has a length of 5/8 inches and a width of 1/4 inch and a volume of 1096. Find the height of the prism. Write your answer as a mixed number. So a rectangular prism is this. It's like a shoebox, right? But here's my best version. There it is, or a stick of butter. So it says we have a length of, I guess I'll make this the length, 5/8. That'll be my length right here. It says we have a width of 1/4 inch. I'll make this 1/4 inch right there. Use a different color scheme. Then a volume of 10 over 96. So you have length, call that L, width. Now you need a, this here, we'll call this length, width, we'll call this the height. Now, my my dimensional labeling is not perfect, but I'm calling that height. Okay, length, width, and height. All right. Yeah, no worries. It'll be fine. So the volume is defined this way. Length times width times height. That's how you find the volume of this three-dimensional rectangular prism. And we know that the volume is 10 over 96. Okay. And we know that the height is unknown. We know that the length is 5/8. And we know that the width is 1/4. So let's substitute. See what happens. So we get 10 over 96 equals 5 over 8 times 1 over 4 times h. So this is an equation with the variable h. We have to solve for h. So what I'll do is I'll just clean this up and multiply 5 times 1 and 8 times 4. That gives me 32. So I now have 10 over 96 equals 5 over 32 times h. You see, that's why we learn how to multiply these fractions, to set up these equations, right? Are you following me? Right? And so what we're going to do here is we're going to solve a one-step equation, all right? We're going to solve a one-step equation by multiplying by the reciprocal. So watch what happens here. We're going to multiply by the reciprocal. And this is a, take this, multiply by the reciprocal. Take this side, multiply by the reciprocal. And that's the power of the reciprocal. Very powerful, because 5 over 5 is 1, right? 32 over 32 is 1, and 1 times 1 is 1, and 1 times h is just h. Here, before we multiply, let's simplify. 5 goes into 5 once, 5 goes into 10 twice. Here, 96. If, let's see, 3, yeah, it goes into it 3 times. Yep. So 32 goes into 32 once, and 32 goes into this 96 3 times. And so my answer is now, you guys ready for this? 2 times 1 is 2. 1 times 3 is 3. And that's my height, 2/3. This, again, is a pretty demanding question. The answer is 2/3. Remember, though, out of the 10 questions, if you get 8 right, it's bonus, right? 8 is 100%. Anything after that is bonus. All right, let's look at number 8. A triangle has a base of 9.4 feet and a height of 2.3. Find the area of the triangle. Write your answer as a decimal. And so what this looks like is the area is 1/2 the base times the height. And so my base is 9.4. And my height is 2.3. So now you substitute. So you've got another formula, 1/2 the base times the height, something we should have seen in a previous course. If you don't know it, that's why you see it now. Wrap that in parentheses. So we can multiply all of this by hand for sure and get an answer. So let's do that. And so what is half of 21.62? So for the sake of time, let me do this. (2) 21.62 / 2
Okay. It's 10.81.
And that's the area. And that's in square units. In this case, it's feet. That's your answer. That's the answer that goes in the box. All right, number 9. I know I'm moving quick. Number 9, you have $49.25 to buy presents for your friend and your brother. You spend $11.95 on the present. How much money can you spend on your friend? Well, you just subtract, right? Yeah, this is, you have all this money, right? $49. But you already spent $11.95, so what's left over for your friend? Right? What's left over? You just subtract. 5 minus 5 is 0. Need to borrow. Make this an 8. Make that a 12. That becomes 3. 8 minus 1 is 7. 4 minus 1 is 3. $37.30. So this is a subtraction problem. Know that. Number 9. All right, we're down to the last question, guys. It has been, a lot of work. So number 10 says a bank charges you some money, right? And for if you have an average monthly balance of your account, if it's less than $4,000, you're going to get charged some money for a monthly fee. The table shows the balance of your account the first 4 months. Find the average monthly balance. So that means you have to add them up and divide by 4, right? You have to pay a fee after the 4th month. So let's add all of these numbers up and then divide by 4 to find the average. So I got to log into my computer here. So I'm going to add these up with my calculator. No fun doing it that way. I mean, I wish I had already done this before I jumped on this video here. I should have had it done. Oh, well. Hindsight's 20/20. So the answer I got when adding all these numbers, I added them up. Added all these up. Why is it moving? So add all these up. And then divide by 4. So adding them up, I get 16,187.15. Now I'm going to divide that by 4. And I'll just use a calculator to do that. And the answer I get is this. My monthly balance, and I'm looking like I have to round off here. I had to round off to the nearest cents. 4,046. So this is my average monthly balance right here. It goes there. So I don't have to pay fees because it's over $4,000. So I do not have to pay fees. Yay. And that's how you do it. All right, everybody. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.